Hello, and welcome back to the second video in the electric mini truck build series. Last time, I dug into the truck to catalog all its components, as well as remove the battery pack for bench testing, and today I'm going to review with you what I found out. To refresh your memory, this truck had not one, not two, but six 12-volt batteries that made up its pack. They were wired in series to produce a 72-volt system. Each of these batteries is a heavy-duty, deep-cycle AGM lead-acid battery. If you are not familiar with lead-acid batteries, AGM, which stands for Absorbed Glass Mat, is very similar to your standard car battery, however they are constructed slightly differently. If you're interested in more details about this style of lead-acid battery or others, let me know in the comments below and I can put together a video about lead-acid batteries and their specific technologies. Each of these batteries, when new, had a rated capacity of 198 amp hours, which gives the entire pack a rating of about 14.25 kilowatt hours. From the factory, Vantage rated this pack size to deliver about 60 miles of range at the truck's limited top speed of 25 miles an hour. Now, I have bigger and better plans for this little truck, however, I wanted to see if I could make it move under its own power first with this original pack. To start off the testing, I took an initial voltage reading of each of the batteries with a digital multimeter. Battery A gave a reading of 3.13 volts, battery B 4.15 volts, C 1.23 volts, D 7.7 volts, E 0.9 volts, and battery F had a reading of 4.46 volts. All of these voltage readings were extremely low and to my knowledge had been at this state for easily a month or two, if not many more. Because of these lower readings, the batteries most likely were not in great condition anymore and had probably already sulfated badly. However, I wanted to take a look and see if any of them might come back to life. I recently picked up a new Noko 10 Genius battery charger, which is capable of charging a couple different chemistries, one of which being AGM batteries. So I figured to give that a shot. It is only a 10 amp capable charger at 12 volts, so it would take quite a while to charge these size batteries. However, given I didn't really know their current state and how things were internally, I figured starting low would be safer. So I gave it a shot, and these are the results. Unfortunately, after a few days of charging, while keeping an eye on the battery's temperature, none of these units would take much of a charge using this charger. With that said, I know there are some methods that attempt to reverse battery sulfation. However, given my plans for the truck, I decided it was time to put these heavy batteries aside and pick up something much lighter that could deliver as much power as I needed. While I want to get this truck back on the road, I want to try and keep the costs as low as I can. As with any EV, the battery pack is typically the most expensive component. Thankfully, due to the many EV projects that are currently going on, from cars to bikes and scooters, secondhand battery cells are fairly easy to get our hands on. So that is what I did. I went ahead and picked up four of these used packs here. These packs are a little bit interesting as they actually came out of electric scooters. Specific company there's been quite a few companies that have been building these scooters and dropping around in cities all around the country, sometimes even around the world, and allowing you to rent the scooters using their app, fully electric, kind of charge and go setup to explore the city. However, this was a bunch that the deal went bad, so now there's a bunch of these available to everybody at a decent price. These specific packs have 40 cells in each of them. They have Panasonic cells that are capable of delivering about 10 amps. And they are in that standard 18650 form factor. So it's a lithium ion cylindrical cell that looks roughly like a AA, but a little bit larger and a little bit longer. So my plan here for these four packs is to wire them together to get about a basically a test pack going. Currently, each of the aluminum cells will deliver 36 volts and about 40 about 460 watt hours. So by tying them in two in series and then two in parallel, that should bring me up to 72 volts and give me just enough power to at least get the motor running and confirm the controller and everything works and maybe push the truck along at a slow speed. So that's going to be the plan. At this point, I am waiting on a few more parts to get these batteries together. They actually have kind of a proprietary signaling method that allows the internal BMS to turn on, which I'll go through in detail once I get my hands on a few more parts. But basically, you need to send a serial signal into the connection port, and that's what wakes up the battery and allows it to charge and discharge.